Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Opening week in the NFL is an exciting time for everybody, including these two teams here today. So let's go now to Houston, Texas, where Jim and Phil are on the call.
The great city of Houston today welcomes a second team into the NFL, and we're here for the first game for this new franchise, and we're nearing kickoff on this most important occasion.
Hello, friends. Jim Nance along with Phil Simms. And Phil, it's the start of a whole new season. There's a sense of renewal in the air and all kinds of hope. And how do you feel about getting this season underway?
Well, I think you're right. It is a lot of hope for all the teams in the NFL, but also what you have in a game like this, opening day, you have nerves. So it's up to the coaches to really put the players in situations where they can get involved in the game and get rid of those nerves, so they can show everything they worked on this offseason can work.
The Houston Oilers are back deep, waiting to return the kick. Graham Gano has it teed up for the opening kickoff. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. Out of USC, number 6, quarterback Mark Sanchez. First down here. The season is underway. Coughs up the football. They recover their own. Johnson in on the tackle.
Nice job that time by the offense. Even though they fumble it, at least they were quick enough and smart enough to get it on it right away.
All right, here we go. Red 18.
Three-step drop. Keekley's able to get a hand on it and knock it away.
Number three.
This offensive line today will be leaned on to protect their quarterback as well as opening up some running lanes. It's Sankey in the backfield.
Red 18.
Sanchez is going to take it from the gun. Going for the home run. Man, intercepted. He stacked up at that point. Heading to the huddle, the quarterback who took his team to the NFC South title in 2013, Cam Newton. First down on the way. The Panthers come out at a 2 tight end set. Marked down after a gain of 4. And the offense here in this one will be looking to put points on the board in bunches. Offense lines up here. Second down and 6. And looking underneath, this will go incomplete. Here's the defense, a unit that works best when it gets to the quarterback. Third down and 6. The defense gets a sack.
Well, that time the quarterback is sacked on the third down, and that's, of course, that's bad. But the good thing is he did not try to force the football down the field and get the turnover.
The Panthers have to punt the football. First down here. the Houston Oilers come out in the pistol.
All right, here we go. Wide and yank. Wide and yank.
Hey. And Walker can't hold on that time. The defensive line will be the focus here in this game. If they're disrupting the quarterback, the rest of the defense will have a chance to do their thing. Second down after the incompletion. Wide receivers stacked up on this play. Looking across the middle, Keekley's there to make the tackle.
Well, they complete the pass, Jim, but doesn't get the first down. Sooner or later, you got to throw one down the field.
Third down and four. Throws to the right. Finds his mark.
What a nice catch by the receiver. Getting past the yard markers, makes the catch, and gets a first down.
Mark Sanchez has it under center. First and 10. Sankey's going to get it out of the eye. Met by Davis that time.
That was a power running play that time by the offense. It picked up some good yards. Nothing like it. Show the defense you're willing to get in there and slug it out and get some tough running yards.
All right, here we go. Wide and yank. Wide and yank.
Second and six. Sankey's going to take the handoff now. And Johnson in on the tackle.
Sankey's a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short game.
It's Sankey in the backfield. Third down and five. And there's Walker. And he's tackled down after picking up the first.
Well, I think we've heard this expression about 7,000 times. It's a passing league, so we all know that. So you got to be able to throw the football and pick up some first downs.
The Oilers will take the snap from the 45. And no one is going to catch this one as it goes out of bounds. Second down now. The Houston Oilers will approach this play from out of the pistol. Sankey's taking the handoff. And now they'll be on the other side of the 50 after this play.
This offense makes it look so easy. Just marching down the field. Now they cross midfield. Let's see what they got going on now.
The Houston Oilers will take the snap from the 45. He's scrambling down. Got ball is out, and the recovery is made by the defense.
That's what you call a takeaway. The defense just makes such a hard hit that they take the football away from the offense and they recover the fumble.
What a place to start for the offense. It's a dime look for the defense on this play. First down and 10. Into the open.
Good job on that touchdown. That puts them ahead, and it's always, of course, better to be ahead than behind.
The Panthers with an extra point try on the way. Add the extra point. The kick is good. Lined up now in kickoff formation. right at about the 28-yard line. They face first down. Offense lines up here.
All right, here we go. Red 18. Red 18.
Mark Sanchez from the gun finds Walker. That's a gain of six.
Number three.
Well, when you keep chipping away with these short throws, sooner or later that defense is going to come up, and when they come up, that's when you throw it over the top.
Ready, wide and yank, wide and yank.
The Oilers have it at the 34. Sankey is going to secure the handoff.
This is one good tackling defense. They stay in good position at all times, and we saw it that time when they stopped the play for a short game.
Right in the slot.
Right, here we go. Red 18. Red 18. Set.
The Houston Oilers snap it at the 36.
To the right side.
And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down.
Games in the NFL can hinge on third and short. Who can pick them up and who can stop them? How about that play that time by the defense? They stopped the third and short run, and now it's fourth down.
What a difficult spot to be in from here. First and 10. Newton, handoff.
It's away from the stack.
The Panthers' offensive line is just whooping some tail today, aren't they? What a job up front. That helps the running back get in space, get down there, and pick up a big game.
First down here after the run. The offense back to the line of scrimmage after going for more than 40 yards on the previous play. Picks up maybe three.
Got to give a lot of credit to the defense. They were all over the run that time, and they only give up a short gain.
Second down and seven. Keeps it here. Running room. Griffin's there to take him down. First down coming up. Handoff. Swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense that time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
Benjamin's a receiver in the slot. Throws the pass. Wayne tackled down.
When you talk about throwing the football into open space, that's almost always against zone defenses. That's what we saw that time. Good job by the quarterback throwing it in there.
Third and eight. Smith's there to catch a ball that had a lot of heat on it. Brown's there to make the tackle.
Well, the way the rules are in the NFL now, you can't hit the receivers, you can't hit the quarterback. And if you give the quarterback this kind of time, he is always going to find an open receiver.
First and goal from the nine. That's a touchdown.
Well, that was just an awful job, wasn't it, by the defense? I mean, it's first and goal. Well, you know it's going to be a run, or I think you should be playing run. The defense not ready. They get overpowered, and they give up the running touchdown.
Everyone's lined up for this kickoff. And no return as this goes for a touchback. The Panthers' offense now marches onto the field.
Here he goes. Red 18.
Now first and 10. Sankey's handed the football. He's tackled. tackle right at the 43. The Houston Oilers trail right now, but you can't blame the running game. Sankey's done more than his fair share here in the first half.
He has done more than his fair share, and the mentality of this offense, they think they are tougher than any defense they play, and so far here today, they have been tougher.
They better hurry to get the snap.
They'll run it here. Tackle down at the 42-yard line. That last running play was good for only a yard, so it's second down and 9.
We ready? Wide and 8. Wide and 8.
Green's got it on the handoff. And gains maybe 4.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
The Oilers take it from the 38. Set up screen. Shakes past the defender. And Keekly in on the tackle.
This is where games are won and lost. Once an offense gets down the red zone, even though they're down more than 7, can you find a way to punch it in there for the touchdown and not settle for a field goal?
Back to the air here on first down. Out of the backfield. Kendall Wright makes the catch.
It's getting harder and harder in the NFL to score when you're this close to the goal line. So what will the offense do? They better be creative. That's all I know.
The defense is ready to plug up the middle here on the goal line. Touchdown. This game is tight. Halftime is coming up, but first we reach the 2-minute warning. The Houston Oilers lined up now for the point after. And the extra point is good. The Panthers will get their hands on the football again, but their lead is not the same. Things are getting tight here. The score's 14-7. He'll take it from the 10. And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line. The Panthers getting ready now to start their drive. Quarters formation here for the defense. First down at the 25. Fights through contact. In on the stop. This will be second down. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Newton's going to take it from the gun. Just 2 yards short of a first down. These rushing numbers stand out because it's not coming from a running back. It's the quarterback, Phil.
Defense has got to be ready. Remember, these quarterbacks who are running the football, they have been running it since youth football, high school, all through college. They're very good at it, and they do it well.
Fine shorts. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
It takes really good corners to play a defense where you challenge the wide receivers and just play them man-to-man coverage. I don't think this defense has that kind of quality corner.
Newton standing back in the shotgun ready for the snap. Sticks to his hands. And he's going to be tackled right around the 43. Second down. Running back in motion here. Quick drop back. Room to work. Avoids the hit and slides. The Panthers call a timeout. Their first. It's first down as they head to the line. Kotcheries lined up in the slot. Cam Newton takes it from the shotgun. Got the completion. He's brought down. The Panthers elect to take a timeout here before the second down snap.
That pass play wasn't good for much. So now it's second down and 9.
Loading up with extra defensive backs in the dime. From the gun, Newton. Has the in the promised land. Touchdown.
You got to take advantage of situations like this. Not often in the NFL do you get somebody this wide open. Good job by the receiver. Nice job by the quarterback. Seeing him. And what do you get? Easy touchdown pass.
Newton's going to look on now from the sidelines. That last drive, he contributed more than 50 yards in the air. Touchback now as the ball comes out to the 20. The Houston Oilers are getting set for their next possession. The defense comes out in the nickel. First and 10. Play fake. He's looking to the right here on this throw.
Quarterbacks always love play action passes. Why? Because it usually gives them a little more time to throw. When you get more time, you're going to make a better decision and you're going to be more accurate.
First down and 10. Looking to the right side and throwing. And it's thrown incomplete.
That was an incomplete pass that time against cover two, the two deep safeties. And you really want to throw the football down the middle or deep down the sidelines. That time the quarterback didn't do that, and that's why it was incomplete.
Double tight end formation.
All right, here we go. Wide and 8.
Second down and 10. Keeps it on the play fake. Sanchez with the deep throw. And they are in on right. The Oilers, one timeout remaining. First down here after the completion. After the long gain, let's see what they do here. Sanchez is going to take it from the gun. Underneath, but can't find a mark that time as the pass goes incomplete. Coming up, second down. It's Sankey in the backfield.
All right, here we go. Wide and 8. Wide and 8.
Out of the gun. Ball's on the ground. And it's a takeaway. He's brought to a halt.
Well, that time the offense fumbles the football, but the defense hit him so hard, there's no chance of hanging on. Hits the ground and the defense recovers.
They come to the line and it's first down. Nickel formation for the defense here. Will run it. Here's the handoff. And that's Woodyard in on the stop. Second down here. So that's going to do it for the first half. Panthers are up in this one.
All right, welcome to the Verizon Halftime Report. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Oilers haven't played their best football and trail because of it. The Panthers will want to come out after the half and really put the pressure on from the start. All right, let's do this. Here's the first half highlights. Oilers have it near the end of one. Here we'll get a fumble on the return. He ended up picking up 32 yards on the play. Now following the turnover, Newton's going to head outside to the right, and he'll take it in for the touch. The Panthers with the early advantage. Panthers take it early in the second. Newton's on target here, and the pass and catch will end up going for 26 yards. Sticking with the same drive, Newton's going to look for a gap, and he'll take this 9 yards for the score. That puts them on top by 14.
Oilers with the ball midway through the second. Sanchez is going to find his mark, and that connection will lead to a gain of 24 yards. Same drive, hand off and run goes up the middle, and he caps off the six-play drive with the score. Trailing now by just a touchdown, Panthers take over late in the second. The connection is made in the middle of the field. This play goes for a score. That puts them on top by 14. So that's it for us. We'll go back now to Houston for the start of the second half.
Arenas on the return. And he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21. They come to the line of scrimmage. First down. Newton lines up in the pistol. The third quarter begins with this play. They'll mark the football at the 22.
Good job by the defensive line standing in there and fighting, and they hold the running back to a short gain.
Cam Newton takes a look now from under center. The Panthers from the 22. Has Olsen, and Phillips is in on the tackle.
Newton selling this play big time. The defense, they go for the run fake, and that's why he has time to throw the football and makes the completion. Good job.
That long gain sets them up here on this play.
Wide to the left.
Breaks out of that one. Picks up about two.
Nice job that time by the defense. They were ready for the run. Nowhere for the running back to go, and they stopped him for a short gain.
Quarters formation here for the defense.
Second down and eight.
Now makes the move to the right. Gains maybe five. The Panthers continue to get their quarterback involved in the run game. Newton's continued to run the ball well here throughout today's game.
Jim, I want to give some props to the offensive coordinator. He has shown a creative side that we have not seen before, creating all these run plays for the quarterback, and man, they are working well. Jim, years ago, you never would have seen a screen pass on third down. But offenses are so varied now, you see it more and more. That was nice execution on that play, and it picked up a first down.
That's a gain of only a yard.
Well, a short gain on the run that time by the offense. When you're a running football team, listen, there's going to be a lot of ugly plays that don't work. You just got to keep running it.
Second and 10. Handoff made. Throws the stiff arm. Nice tackle.
Jim, the offensive coordinator's done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. You're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
First down at the 15. They're setting up screen. They knock him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Got to give the defense some credit on first down. There's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
For this play, they'll go with two tight ends. Newton can't find the target, and it's incomplete.
This is a tough situation for the offense. Third and long coming up, but it's a good situation also. You're leading the football game, so there's no reason to take a chance and turn this football over.
Third down and 11. And now he'll slide. And looking now at these rushing totals, obviously they don't want their quarterback taking too many hits, but he's running the ball so well, you have to let him continue to do it here in the second half, Phil.
Oh, no doubt about it, Jim. Now it's just about winning the football game. And if that means your quarterback's going to run the football, then so be it.
First and goal to go from the two. Searching for space to the right, and he's in for the touchdown.
Oh, you just love it as a quarterback. You get down in there, and it's first and goal. If you score, now you don't have to sweat the fact that, man, what are we going to do if he gets the third down? You don't have to worry about it. Good run, nice touchdown.
The Houston Oilers now have even more work to do to get back into this one. Scores 28-7. That'll be a touchback, and the ball will be placed at the 20. The Houston Oilers are ready to take over now as their offense heads onto the field. Coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time. First down at the 20. Launches it down the field. And it's incomplete. And Phil, in a close game where neither quarterback has played well, is going to be interesting to see who steps up at the end.
Yeah, you got to know as a quarterback in situations like this that it's probably not going to get better. So you got to deal with it mentally and try to fight through it and make some plays down the stretch.
Second down and 10. Knocked away, incomplete.
Good job by the linebacker that time. Saw the receiver coming in his area, read the quarterback, and in wonderful position to knock the pass down.
Britt's going to get set in the slot for this snap.
Red 18, set.
Third and 10. Sanchez with the deep throw. And Deku nearly picks the pass off.
Well, the defense is happy to get off the field. They stopped the third down try by the offense, but they're upset because they had a chance for the turnover, and they dropped a sure interception.
And that'll be a gain of about 2.
Well, I can't blame the punt return at that time. That was just excellent coverage by the punt team.
Newton's going to be in the pistol here. First down at the 46. They'll go ground. Amukamara is the one who brings him to the ground.
I think the coach on the sidelines, he's going to be happy with every first down because he knows that's more time off the clock. When you're up like this, multiple scores in the second half, every first down just puts the odds in your favor of winning this game.
They'll go ground. Wembley's there to take him down. Second down coming up. Offense lines up here. The give. And they knock him down just a yard away from the first. The defense looking for one more stop here on third down after that run. Offense lines up here. Newton still has it. Makes the catch inbounds.
Newton's job.
That play is going to be challenged. Challenge flag is out. There's no question he caught the ball, but there is a question whether or not he got both feet in bounds.
Well, first off, you want to make sure it's a clean catch on the sidelines. Does he have possession of the football? And then once you declare he has possession of the football, let's look down at both feet, see if they're in bounds, and don't forget, you must maintain possession of the football as you go to the ground.
So he challenged the play, and the coach's challenge does not pay off.
Well, I agree with the head coach still. I would have made this challenge because it was so important to the outcome of the game, and it was a little bit of a gamble, but it was worth it.
First and 10. Strong eye, handoff here. Cox is there that time for the tackle. That leads us to second down. To the right side, Pollard's in on the tackle.
Well, when you get a couple first downs, it just gives you such great confidence. It makes everybody relax. And I always say this, when you're a relaxed athlete, that's when you play your best.
They're able to move the chains after that last run. The Panthers pistol set here. The final quarter begins with this snap. Griffin's going to make the tackle. Looking ahead, the Oilers will be on the road in New England next week, while the Panthers will be playing at home next week. And it'll be second down and 6 after the running play on first down. Offense lines up here. Dropping back 3. He'll be taken down about 3 yards short of the first.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
Newton in shotgun formation. unable to bring it in.
Sometimes on the defensive side, hurrying the quarterback is just as good as sacking him, because when you hurry him, he doesn't have time to think. He's probably not going to be as accurate, and they get the incompletion. Good job by the defense.
The kick is good.
That was a good hold, good kick, 3 points. Good job by the offense.
He's put the ball on the tee, and he's about to kick off. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. The Oilers now ready to take over as their offense heads onto the field. Britz lined up now as a slot receiver.
Red 18.
First down at the 23. And there's Walker, tackled down at the 28-yard line.
Sometimes it's good protection by the offensive line, and sometimes it's just bad defense. They can't get to the quarterback, and that's another completion by
him. Red 18.
Second down and 6. Play fake. No separation at all. Incomplete.
Good job that time by the secondary. They're in good position. They make the play, and it's an incomplete pass by the quarterback.
Offense lines up here.
Here we go. Wide and yank. Wide and yank.
Third and 6. Has a catch for the first.
Zone defense doesn't work in the NFL like it used to. Good job by the quarterback reading that zone and finding the open guy.
From the gun, Mark Sanchez ready for the snap. Now first and 10. Ball comes out. The defense has the football. They bring him to the turf.
Well, that's what you call a take. That time the defense just hit the ball carrier so hard that he had to give the football up, and they lose it.
First and 10. Here's the handoff off the right side. Brought down after a gain of 6. That'll be 2nd and 4 after the running play. An extra tight end on the field for this one. Middle tackled just 3 yards short of the first. It'll be 3rd down. Offense lines up here. The give out of the eye. That's been the story of this game. Another 3rd down conversion to move the chains.
Good job by the offensive line there on 3rd and short. Even though the defense knew it was probably going to be a run, still able to get in there and barely get that 1st down.
He'll go left. He's brought down at the 20-yard line.
The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
That's 2nd down coming up.
It is without a doubt the worst place to get pressure up the middle on the quarterback. It happened that time, and he did the right thing. Just take the sack.
Kotchery is in the slot. Just 2 minutes left in this one now. Back in a moment. It's 3rd down coming up. Coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a 3rd time. This time, they fail to pick up the 1st on 3rd down. A rare occurrence here today. Lining up for a 38-yard field goal. And the kick is good for 3.
When you get great field position, Jim, you got to take advantage of it. The offense didn't do it. I blame the coach. Those were terrible play calls, but a good kick by the kicker.
And the tackles made right around the 26-yard line. First down, offense readying for the snap.
All right, here we go.
Just a quick drop back.
That's a ball that should have been caught.
Do one thing at a time. Catch the football, then do the next thing, run with it. He tried to run with it too quick. That's why he dropped it.
They've come out in the dime package.
All right, here we go. Red 18. Red 18.
They'll hike it to him out of the shotgun. It's right. Then picks up about three.
Well, I guess the best thing to say there, Jim, is they completed a pass, but it still did not get a first down.
The Houston Oilers lined up in the pistol.
Red 18! Red 18!
Third down and eight. He'll keep it on the play fake. He's got the catch. That'll put them in what we call plus territory.
Well, you're really in a tough spot, but that is a good job picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. All you can do, just keep picking up those first downs. You hope it leads you to a score, and then you play the game from there.
Heaving it down the field. Hauls it in. What a call and what a catch.
Well, who are we kidding? They're driving the football down the field, and they're in the red zone. They're getting blown out, and what difference does it make if they score now or not? Nothing.
First and goal from the two. It's a touchdown.
If you go to an NFL practice, they spend about 40% of their time practicing plays going in to score. That's why they made it look so easy here. Nice throw by the quarterback on first and goal.
The Houston Oilers now will tack on the extra point. Makes the PAT. The Oilers kicking team comes out now as the offense takes a break, and they deserve one after going down the field, mainly through the air with over 70 yards passing. Ryan Succop ready for the kickoff. And a touchback here will bring the ball out to the 20. The Panthers get ready to start their drive. Nickel formation here for the defense. Takes the knee. It's now second down. How hard is it to deal with an opening week loss in this league?
It is so tough because you put in so much work, so much planning. You're really playing for about 3 weeks to get ready to play that opening game. And to lose it, it's really hard to deal with.
What a memorable game this truly was. For Phil Simms, Danielle Bellini, and Larry Ridley, Jim Nance saying so long for now, and we leave you with the GMC Never Say Never moment of the game.